Hi everyone. Happy Sunday. Happy Sultry Hangout. My name is Alyssa.
And I'm Tony, and we're the Sultry Sisters. Yay! And so today we're doing something a little bit different because Sundays are usually our Sultry Hangout. So if you guys have been rocking with us for a while, you know that our Sultry Hangouts are usually on IG Live, so Instagram. But for you all, we're doing our book club, and we love doing our book club on Facebook because guess what? We could go through StreamYard. So how you guys are seeing us now. And so we are really excited to have our book club again. We started this last year around this same time, and we read the Four Agreements, and that was really fun, and our community really enjoyed it. So we're like a year later, like, let's do another book club. Like this time of year, I feel like it's nice. You can read your book outside. And so it's a way for us to talk about the books that we're reading and discuss further into how we're applying it in our life. And so basically our Sultry Book Club is a way for us to elevate our mind, body, and soul. So taking care of ourselves through reading and through activating the mind. So that's really fun. And it's also a way for us to collectively heal since we're all coming together as one for this.
Yes, and I wanted to also add, because this is a live event, because we're streaming live here on Facebook Live, please let us know if you're joining us on the stream. Let us know where you're tuning in from. Let us know if you participated in our last year's book club. And we would love to get to know you through this. This is an interactive book club series. So feel free as we go along to type in the chat, and we want to engage with you that way. So just want to set that and welcome you to engage with us.
Yes. And so this month of June for Sultry Sisters, we're focusing on the art of reading. So that's why we're having our Sultry Book Club. And it's a safe space for us to discuss like our thoughts and reflections on the book that we're reading. And just like a note, although this is a book club and we are sharing our thoughts on find boundaries or set boundaries, find peace. If you haven't read the book, that's okay too. We'll talk about that a little bit more later. But this is just a way for us to discuss and kind of talk about, what we've been learning, and to dive deeper into some of the topics or questions that get posed in the book. So that's really exciting. And I just remember from last year, it's just so fulfilling to like be able to share like our takeaways from a book, get all of y'all's takeaways, your I don't know, like opinions on things, or when we open it up for you all to share, like what you've been thinking, maybe how this applies to your life. I always find it really, like, what do you call that? Fulfilling.
Yes, and it's nice. Like for me, like I love doing things in community. I'm all about the collective healing, and also I'm all about co conversation. So that's what brings me to the book club series. And I just want to shout out some people who are tuning in with us live. We have Larry. Hi, Larry. Let us know where you're tuning in from. And then we have Aja Marie from Los Angeles. Hey, thank you for joining us.
Yes, and that's Asia. So we went to our herbalism. She was part of my Hood Herbalism
Awesome.
tour. So yes, I'm so excited for you all to be joining us. If you haven't already and you're joining with us live, please do comment below your name, where you're tuning in from. You all can also chat below like what you're excited about for this book club series. If you've joined our series before, I know Larry has joined before. I don't know anyone else who's online. If you have done our book club last year, please let us know. We'd love to be reminded of who's in the house with us.
Yes. So we first want to just let you know what our featured book, Tony, let us know. What is the featured book this year, this series?
So we are featuring Set Boundaries, Find Peace by Nidra Glover-Taleb. And this is it. Alyssa has as well. So I gifted it to myself and Alyssa. Basically, a lot of the books, like if I get for myself, I'm like, oh, Alyssa, she'd probably like this too. Oh, and then my bookshelf is right here. So my little studious place. Oh yeah, and Alyssa's bookshelf is right there too. And so yeah, I chose this book because if you all follow my leek teal, she's like a Black businesswoman and has like an Instagram page. She talked about this book, and I remember her talking about the book and the author, and I was just like, oh my God, this is amazing. Like Nidra, the author, I'll talk about her in a little bit, but it's a Black woman. So I thought, I love supporting like Black writers and things like that. And Alyssa and I both love like self-development books. This is right up our alley. Because sometimes, yeah, because The Four Agreements is also kind of like a self-help book. And this one is similar. But you can also comment below if there's any other books you would like us to potentially do a book club in the future. But yeah, so really excited about that. So yeah, do you want to?
Yes. And we also want to ask y'all, we want to do a poll, like, have you read this book before? Are there any first-time readers? Let us know in the chat if you have heard of the author Nidra, if you follow her already on IG. She does a lot of her engagement on there. And let us know if you're planning on getting the book now that you're a part of this series. I also wanted to briefly talk about why we chose to feature this book. And I want to share a quote by Nidra. And she shared, the root of self-care is setting boundaries. And those of you who are new to the Soul Tree sister community, we are all about soul care. And the root of soul care is self-care, taking care of the self. And so when Tony and I saw this, we're like, ooh, this is definitely a reason why we think it's important to bring this book to our community, because a big part of understanding boundaries is knowing that it is rooted in self-care.
Yes. One more time for the people in the back. Okay. The root of self-care is setting boundaries. And today and throughout the whole month of June, we'll be breaking down what boundaries are, what that means, the different kinds of boundaries, what that looks like. And in this book, I really love it because she has exercises and journal prompts that we'll be sharing with you all as well that helps you reflect on like boundaries in your life, you know, how you've learned about them, you know, types of boundaries that you can improve, and like actionable steps to improve boundaries and relationships. So that's what I really love. But yes, boundaries are so important. And yeah, the one thing what really set apart this book from other like self-help books, in my opinion, was that it really does focus on self-care. And like the title, Set Boundaries, Find Peace, but then the like subtitle is A Guide to Reclaiming Yourself. And so I think it's just so true. Like now that I've read the book, that it really is a way to reclaim, because sometimes, you know, like through growing up or us like being socialized and conditioned in our different lifestyles, we think that like, oh, this is how it has to be, or this is how my relationship with this person always is. And sometimes we dread it or regret it or something. But I love this book to show how you are really the driver of the relationships in your life, and you create the dynamic in the relationships you have, whether you're aware of it or not, or conscious or not of it. So I found that to be really intriguing as well.
Yeah, I would say what sticks out to me too is like normalizing communicating our needs and communicating when our needs aren't met. I feel like that's a part of self-care that doesn't get talked about a lot. Self-care is normally like treat yourself. And it's normally not saying like, oh, self-care is communicating the need for care or the disappointment with the lack of care. So that's what really is my interest in diving more into this book. And what I'm really excited to share with y'all is that like, let's get to the root of self-care. She really does pack a lot of gems in here. And today really is just about introducing some of the definitions of boundaries. And also we want to walk you next through what to expect through this month.
Yeah. So throughout all of June, so this week and the coming weeks, we'll be reading this book, of course. But with us at Soul Tree, we always kind of do our own Soul Tree mix, remix on things. So if you all have been a part of different book clubs before for like other organizations or other communities, you probably had finished the whole book first, and then you come together and just kind of have like a dialogue, talk about it, and then go your separate ways. But with Soultry, we like to kind of read it as we're going along with you all. I mean, like, I have read the whole thing basically already, but still, like, I'm rereading along each week. Alyssa is reading it in real time with you all if you chose to get the book. But we break it down into sections so they're more digestible, I guess. Mm-hmm. And we can kind of focus the conversation each week on a certain area of the book. So first week today, for all of you here joining us, is the introduction. So of course, we're introducing the book, the author, you know, like why we chose the book. And then we're also talking about the importance of boundaries. So just, you know, like why are boundaries important? Why do we have them? You know, why should we be trying to, you know, improve boundaries in our lives? And then, you know, different like healthy, unhealthy aspects that boundaries can show up in our lives. And then next week, we'll be talking about the different types of boundaries. So, you know, you have boundaries in your family, in your romantic relationships, friendships, work, with yourself. That's like the biggest thing in this book, honestly, for me, is like that. Yeah. Himself. And then social media. So I thought that was cool too, how she mentioned social media as like an aspect of boundaries. Mm-hmm. And then week three, we'll talk about communicating boundaries, which is so important because a lot of us, you know, can have boundaries in our head, in our mind, in our spirits, but do we really tell people what that boundaries are? So she gives us some ways to kind of do that. And then the fourth week, to wrap up, is doing the work of setting boundaries. So it's really going to be focused more on like the actionable steps that we can take in our lives and the different boundaries that we have and work, et cetera. And then also like, how do we honor our boundaries? Like that's the word she uses. So also like different ways that we can make sure that we're staying true to ourselves, like as we're going on this journey. So yeah, that's the main thing. We're here on Facebook Live every Sunday. Yeah. At 5 p.m. Pacific time, 8 p.m. Eastern time. So mm-hmm. Same place, same time. I don't know what else you want to add.
Yeah, and then also a big part of this book club and the big reason why we like to feature these specific books is a space for reflection. So a lot of this work that we're going to be doing together on this live, we're going to be leaving you with journal prompts and reflection questions, because the reason why we're doing this in real time is because the art of reading is a practice. You know, we want to be able to digest everything in real time so that it has a lasting effect. And that's why we are doing it in this series and manner and way. So we just wanted to share with you our intentions, what we hope to get out of this process with you all. And then also for our sanctuary members, if you're a part of our sanctuary, you will get these live recordings a part of the membership. So those of you who are tuning in with us on Facebook, you're going to be able to access this with us live. And then after that, if you want to access it like for eternity after this, it will be available on our membership. So we just wanted to also give y'all that information. If you're interested in joining our Soultry Sanctuary, you can learn more at soultrysisters.com. Yeah. And you'll be able to learn more and join us there.
Yeah, so visit our website, soultrysisters.com, to check out our sanctuary or to sign up for the sanctuary. And then, of course, follow us on Instagram, Facebook. Well, you're already here on Facebook, but definitely like us on Facebook. Follow us on Instagram. We have LinkedIn, all those things, to stay updated on what we're doing in our community. So if you have any questions about, like, the logistics, you can either message us or you can put in the comments below, and then we'll get to that as well. And just a tidbit. During our lives all the time, we love interaction. We love, you know, dialogue. We love talking with you all, conversations. So please, please, please feel free to add things in the comments section, and we'll, we can share your comments if it's a response, or mm-hmm. we can also, answer any questions that you have. So
yes, we had a few more people join the live. We have Gaia in the house. We have Soulfree Mom in the house. We have Cousin Stanley. So thank y'all for joining us. And with no further ado, let's get into the nitty gritty of this book, and let's talk a little bit about the author. Tony, tell us about Nidra.
Yes. So Nidra is a Black woman. amazing. So she is a licensed therapist, a clinical social worker, a content creator, and an author, of course. So we all are reading her book. And what's I found really interesting about Nidra is that she was really, I guess, famous or viral on Instagram for her like therapist type of tweets or posts. And then that's actually what kind of inspired her to write the book, because she was writing such like great content on Instagram that people were like, oh my God, we need more. We need more. So she's like, okay, I can give you more in a book. So definitely check out this book. Of course, I am an avid supporter of your local library. So check out your local library to see if you can check out the book there or even online digitally. Like my library, I have like an online card, and like I actually was able to check it out like an audiobook as well. So it's also available through audiobook. So you can check it out on Audible or your library.
Yes, I want to answer a question before we get into more. Larry has a question. So have you started reading the book yet? So the answer is yes and no. Tony has already read through the book. Tony is our book club series. I guess she screens the books. And then she's an avid book reader. So she's always reading tons of books. And we then decide together which books we're going to feature. And so for me, no, I haven't read the book. I've read as far as chapter 3, just to get us prepared for today's conversation. So I always read the book in real time with y'all. So we have one person over here, read the book, screened it, loved it, yes. And then me over here having the same experience as y'all. So we're on and in for a ride.
Yes. So yeah, if you haven't read the book, you haven't opened up the book, it's totally fine. Also, the way this book is written, it's very like easy to read. So even if you were to pick it up like in the next few weeks or something, I feel like you would still be caught up because it's really like straightforward, which I appreciate. And also it's like a self-help book. So I feel like even if you don't read it, through being here in community and being a part of this conversation and the dialogue, then you're getting, you know, the benefits of this book as well. Yes. So even if you don't feel like getting the book, just coming here, being part of the conversation, and feel free to chat with us as well, because we'll have parts where we have questions for you all to share your responses with us. So yeah, so I hope that answered all of y'all's questions. But yeah, if you have any other questions, feel free to comment below.
All right, let's go into part one, understanding the importance of boundaries. So we just want to shoot a question out to our people that are engaging with us. What do you think boundaries are? Before we even get started, understanding the importance of boundaries to you, how do you define boundaries? Let us know in the chat.
Yes. Like, what do boundaries mean to you? And if you don't want to say like what boundaries are, you can also say like, is there any part of your life that you're trying to work on? Well, we'll kind of talk about this later, but just right now, before we talk about boundaries, like your first thought, like, do you feel like you have good boundaries in your life, or do you feel like you're trying to improve the boundaries in your life?
Yeah. Where are you in your boundaries journey? So I'm putting here, how do you define boundaries? And then the follow-up question is, how do you feel you stand with enforcing them, sharing them, living by them, using them as a tool?
Mm-hmm. So yes, please comment below. Okay, Sultry Mama, so Evangeline says boundaries are setting limits. Yes, so very true. So yeah, setting limits could be so many things. And I also like in the book how Nidra is kind of broad in her definition. We'll talk about the definition in a bit, but I think it encompasses a lot. And then Larry says boundaries are something I'm learning. Oh, it is something I'm learning to set boundaries for myself, as in what are my boundaries? That's a question all of us can just like inwardly reflect right now. Is like, what are my boundaries?
And I think a good way to ask that question, because it's always hard to think about ourselves, but maybe ask, when has a boundary been set on you? Like, has anyone shared a boundary with you? That might be helpful to understanding a boundary when it was placed upon you. Like, hey, don't pass this line. Because for me, it was hard when I thought about myself. I'm like, I don't know. But when you think about somebody else, it's a little easier.
And then Asia says creating space and limits. Definitely
gotten
better with boundaries, but want to improve, especially with family. Yes.
Yes. And in this book, Nidra talks about how this is the hardest category to set boundaries. So we hear you, we are with you, and we're interested in learning more together.
Yes. And Alyssa, when you're talking about, like, oh, what is an example of a time when, you know, someone had like it put a boundary between you and that person. And I feel like this past year with COVID honestly has been like a example of like having conversations about boundaries, boundary setting. If people are respecting your boundaries, you know, like with standing 6 feet apart, like I remember being at an airport and like someone was like right behind me and I was like, 6 feet, sir, like you are too close to me. So something like that, even like asking friends like, oh, hey, are you comfortable to hang out? Like, are you comfortable wearing a mask? Can we take off the mask? You know, should we meet outdoors? Can we meet inside your apartment? You know, things like that, I feel like, are if you had to do that during this pandemic, which a lot of us have, that's an example of setting boundaries.
Yeah. And honestly, I feel like this book couldn't come at a more timely, at a better time, because this is the time to practice communicating boundaries, you know, as people are getting vaccinated or coming back to work and engaging. It's going to be so important to decide what our boundaries are so we can function in social engagements with our family at work. So that's also why I think this is an important time to check in with ourselves so that we're able to navigate.
Yeah, definitely. And then Chanel puts boundaries are like personal guidelines that can be linked to our individual values as well. Ooh, I love that. Yes, Chanel.
That brings me back to the four agreements, Chanel. Oh. Our values. Yes.
Mm-hmm. And yeah, so boundaries are so important. And yeah, one thing that Nidra points out is that like, whether we're like aware of it or not, there's boundaries in our life. And we're either people who have like healthy ones or unhealthy ones. So yeah, like I'll share the definition of boundaries, but before that, I'll share what Nidra puts as like some of the signs that you need boundaries. Cause like maybe you're thinking right now, like, oh, actually, like I'm fine. So some of the things she says is like in the introduction, she says like, if you feel overwhelmed, that can be a sign that you need boundaries. So especially like in work, like if you feel like you're working so much or your boss is asking you to work overtime and you keep saying yes, that can be overwhelmed in your family life. If you feel resentment towards people for asking you for help, also if you avoid phone calls and interactions with people you think might ask for something.
Avoidance.
Yeah, so I've felt that before. You make comments about helping people and getting nothing in return. So if you feel like some relationships are not reciprocal or mutual, you feel burned out. I think a lot of us can say we've experienced that, especially like with the pandemic and like having everything virtual, you know, like Zoom fatigue and all of that.
Boundaries with social media, burned out.
You frequently daydream about dropping everything and disappearing. So, you know, just sit with that one a little bit if you're feeling that. And you have no time for yourself is the last sign that she says that you need boundaries. And I was like, she's talking about me.
So let us know in the comments if any of those struck a chord with you. So again, Tony was sharing signs that you need boundaries have to deal with if you feel overwhelmed, resentment for people asking for help, not wanting to answer phone calls, all those things. Let us know in the comments if you've ever felt that way. Mm-hmm. I know I have.
Yeah. There was so many that I was like checking off. I was just like, oh God, that's like page, like that's in the introduction. That's not even the first page.
That's not even the first chapter, y'all. I never thought that feeling overwhelmed was a sign that I needed boundaries, because I've always valued being needed. Mm-hmm. I've always valued people. When people ask me for help, I'm like, yes. Oh yeah. And I'm like, oh, that is a boundary that I do not have. So we'll talk more about that, but I just wanted to share personally, like something that I thought was a good attribute of myself, that I'm always saying yes and I always want to help, was a sign that your girl does not have a boundary around that.
Yeah, and so for chapter one, it's called What the Heck Are Boundaries? So she really kind of goes through like what are boundaries and all that stuff. And the first like subtitle of the chapter is Boundaries Are the Gateway to Healthy Relationships. And I love that she shares it's the gateway, because it really is like when you change your perspective or your mindset on that, it's like having boundaries. Like I think a lot of people think boundaries are like it blocks you in, you know, it's like restricting you or closing you off from stuff. But I love how she said it's actually a gateway. So actually having these boundaries and these guidelines and this space and limits that you've all shared, that allows us to then have healthy, you know, mutual reciprocal relationships. I think that's so important. But before we continue talking about boundaries, I will share Nidra's definition just so we're all on the same page. Oh yeah, and then Jessica had shared that, yeah, she has felt the need to disappear and then wanting a vacation
because yes.
of boundaries, yes.
So wanting a vacation is a good barometer of like, oh, I need a vacation. That means I need to set some boundaries. Like, yeah, so yes, girl, we hear you. I feel you, yes.
Yeah, so I'll share the definition. So on page 5, if you have the physical copy of the book, on page 5, Nidra shares her definition of boundaries. So I'll just read it aloud for everyone. So boundaries are expectations and needs that help you feel safe and comfortable in your relationships. So I think that's so important, safe and comfortable. Expectations and relationships help you stay mentally and emotionally well. Learning when to say no and when to say yes is also an essential part of feeling comfortable when interacting with others. So I love how she shares it's expectations, it's needs. So not even like a want, it's like a need, like I need this to be. And she says mentally and emotionally well, which I think so many of us can, or I'll just speak for myself. I feel like for me, like if I think I'm physically fine, like, oh, I can, you know, stay up and like work on this assignment or whatever when I had school. But then when I think about it, it's like, but was I mentally or emotionally well? You know, so I think having that like holistic aspect of your wellness helps you like implement these boundaries. And I love how she says it's an essential part of feeling like comfortable and safe. Cause like, I think that also ties back into COVID. Like when we had to communicate our boundaries to people, it's like, okay, am I comfortable? Like them not wearing a mask, you know, do I feel safe if like they're not vaccinated and I'm hanging out, you know what I mean? So I think if we think about the COVID example, it could be easier for some people who, if they don't,
because we're living in it.
Exactly. So yeah, that's her definition. So we're all kind of on the same page about that. Did you want to add anything, Alyssa?
No, I think I love that definition because I like that it's not just needs, it's expectations. Because a lot of times we just think about, like you said, Tony, you said needs, but the expectations, like how would you like to ideally engage at work? How do you ideally want to engage with your partner? How do you ideally want to engage with their family? And there's no shame in like wanting an ideal situation of how you want someone to call you, how you want someone to touch you, how you want someone to ask of you, how someone expects you to show up. I think that's, we're going to dig into that deeper. But for me, I really resonate with this definition because it's rooted around how we feel about it, not like boundaries are about pushing someone away. It's almost about how you would like to invite them in.
Yes. Yeah, totally that. And I feel like also with her perspective on boundaries, I feel like it's also like, how are you sustaining yourself in your life? And that's why I like how she also breaks it down to like family, mm-hmm. relationships, friendships, work, and social media, because it's really
yes.
sustaining in all these aspects. Because, and also it's, she'll talk, we'll talk more about this later, but your boundaries in one aspect of your life could be different in others. Like,
yes.
Well, she was like, oh, you can say like, oh, I don't hang out with my coworkers and stuff. But then you could have, you know, a boundary with your friends of like, oh, like we like to do XYZ thing. I don't know. About
it. I think what's really important about the boundaries aspect is also, like I said, inviting in. And what we're saying is sustaining. Like I want to have a relationship with my sister. We work together. Right? We have sultry sisters. We have to have boundaries of when we have sistivities that is just like us, just being us. And then like when it's soul tree stuff. So even like here on this working, being engaging with y'all, like we are still practicing boundaries too. Cause you know, I know T on her, she knows T on me, but we're not going to share it as a boundary. right, Tony, there's boundaries.
Yes, there are boundaries, aka the outline that we'll be following. But anyway,
I love how Jada said this. Yes, boundaries are about how you like to invite them in. And the reason why I say that is because it's inspired by some gems that and examples that Nidra has in the book when she talks about shoes and home. So I don't want to spoil it, but just want to say, yeah, inviting people in. Mm-hmm. Oh, look what social mama said. There's a boundary.
No coworker friends on Facebook, right? Mm-hmm. Or Instagram or whatever your like social media thing is, or even, you know, not being on like texting basis with coworkers sometimes, like, oh, I prefer email, you know, so.
It's all about what you prefer, because we do want to engage. We are social beings, like with the pandemic, like at the end of the day, even though we were in isolation, we still crave connection. It's just like, we get to name how we'd like to connect. And that's what I like about this reclaiming ourselves is that what I'm looking forward to is like, yeah, just creating my own recipe on how I'd like to engage with people. And guess what? Recipes can change every day. Talking about food, one day you want Thai, one day you want, you know, some sandwich. I don't know. I'm just saying it's okay to, and we're gonna actually segue into that, talking about the different levels of boundaries, right, Tony?
Mm-hmm. Yeah, so yeah, we kind of described the definition that Nidra has of what boundaries are. Everyone kind of shared here what boundaries are. And so Nidra shares that there's three levels to boundaries, and I'll go over that. And so with the different levels of boundaries, it's just kind of a way to describe like how, it's kind of a way to categorize like the different boundaries we have in our lives and assess like, are they healthy or can they be improved, you know? So the first level, or like one of the levels, is porous boundaries. And so porous boundaries are, I'm just reading it from the book. This is page 10. So if you're reading with us, page 10. So porous boundaries are weak or poorly expressed and are unintentionally harmful. They lead to feeling depleted, overextending yourself, depression, anxiety, and unhealthy relationship dynamics. And so porous boundaries can look like oversharing, codependency, enmeshment. So lacking emotional separation between you and someone else. There's inability to say no, people pleasing, depending on feedback of others, a fear of being rejected, and mm-hmm. accepting being mistreated. So if any of those things you felt like, oh, like a ding, 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 then that's an example of having a porous boundary. And with this book and like talking about boundaries and stuff, there's no like right or wrong. Like if you are reflecting right now and you're just like, oh, wow, like I have a lot of kind of unhealthy boundaries right now in my life, like, we're not trying to do this to make you feel bad and like, oh my God, I'm in like not a good place. This is all just a way, like a tool to reflect and then hopefully inspire you and, you know, support you in creating more healthy boundaries. So I also wanted to put that
yes.
out. This is not like, oh, if you're all in this one category, then like you're doing everything wrong. But this is just a way to reflect and yes. hopefully, you know, support you in this.
Mm-hmm. And porous boundaries are very subtle. So they're not boundaries that are like very, very set that you're aware of. Tony, can you think of like a porous boundary that you have or a porous boundary example?
Yeah, like for me, kind of like you said earlier, but like saying yes to things, like even though inside I know that like actually I am tired, like so like my schedule before, like I was a full-time grad student, I was like working, of course I have Sultry, so like I have a business, and then I help on like other things. I was in like a student org, I help with this yoga group. So at one point I was like saying yes to helping with like another organization and stuff. And I had to tell myself like, Tony, like this is not healthy for you. Like, you know, you only have like so many hours in a day And like, just because you're available doesn't mean you're free to do these things. So I did have to practice boundaries of like, okay, saying no to certain things, like, no, I can't help out with XYZ thing. And then also not even just like, not even a, not extreme, but it doesn't have to be just completely saying no to something. But also I've had to kind of navigate like, okay, yes, but kind of thing, like,
yes,
okay, I can do this specific thing, or at this time I'm available. So also being more specific. So not just totally saying no, but saying like, okay, if I do engage in this thing, like, this is what I can do, or this is what my capacity is.
Yeah, I hear you. And I would say my example, when I reflect on a porous boundary, is when people pronounce my name wrong. Oh, it's fine. Like, you can, how do you say your last name? And I'm like, oh, it's just whatever. That is a porous boundary. Like, I'm just saying an example. Like, it doesn't have to be like people asking of you a lot. It could be something as simple as like a porous boundary can be like, you go to a restaurant and you say you don't want a certain, you say, I don't want carrots in my fried rice, and they put carrots in your fried rice and they bring it to you, and you're like, it's okay, I'll just pick it out. That's a porous boundary. I know, and I just want to say, like, it can seem very trivial, but when it comes to porous boundaries, I feel like they're weak and they're so small that it's one of those things that pile up. It's a lot of things that are just, you know, that will exhaust you. So I just wanted to bring that up, like, to also share, like, these boundaries is like, it goes deep, but it's also very like at the surface too, with how you engage with ordering food.
Yeah, and I think that also, Alyssa, you sharing that example is good, because you can also maybe reflect, like, people, not you, Alyssa, I'm saying people in general can reflect, and like, maybe in these smaller things in your life, if you are even more porous than that, like, that might also help you reflect on like, okay, that kind of does become a pattern in other parts of your life. Maybe, maybe not, but sometimes that could be like, if you're a person who never really speaks up at a restaurant, which is like a stranger, a person doing their job, who, like, you know, it is there, it's also their best interest to make sure that your dish is great. But if you don't feel comfortable to communicate your boundary with them, then, like, you know, maybe with people in your family or your relationships, that's like more like emotionally tied, then yes, it's even harder to communicate, yeah, boundaries, because you feel mm-hmm. more oh my God, like, why am I doing this?
Exactly. If you're tuning in, let us know in the chat if you can identify a porous boundary that you've experienced. We would love to know. And I think the main thing about what we're doing right now with defining the different types of levels of boundaries is just to normalize and show like how it's not much to ask for the right order, and it's not much to ask someone to call you by your name in which you would like it to be pronounced. It's okay to say, excuse me, do you mind referring to me as this? Or excuse me, do you mind if you, you know, if I get what I ordered? It's okay. I just want to give space that to normalize that.
Yeah. And also, I guess it's kind of similar, but like when she was, Nija says like porous boundaries could also look like people pleasing. And I think sometimes that term, I feel like a lot of people are familiar with, but I don't think everyone will have maybe like a grasp of like how that shows up in their life. But Alyssa, like you said, like even ordering food, like if you don't feel comfortable to say your boundary is like, oh, I can't have meat because I'm a vegetarian or something, and then they still put meat in your dish or something, then that could be like, oh, people pleasing, because like, oh, it's like a work potluck, and like you don't want someone to like feel bad that they like, you know, made this dish, and like, but it's against like, you know, your eating values and stuff like that. So that's something to think about too. And then porous, yeah, for me, it was the main thing that came up was like saying no to like things when I was really like overwhelmed. But feel free to comment below, like, now that we've shared what porous boundaries are like, if anything came up for you, and we can share that aloud with everyone.
And while that happens, we can start talking about rigid boundaries. Oh, I want to share this, what Larry said. I learned a lot about boundaries from me. That's news to me, Larry. I'm glad. I'm glad I exercise some sort of boundary. I mean, I know I do. We all do. But it's just being more aware of the different levels for me. I feel like certain levels I'm good at and certain levels not so great. For me, I have a lot of porous boundaries that I recognize. I do have rigid ones, but it's just that the porous category really got me.
Mm-hmm. or I feel like also with Porous, and then we can move on, but with Porous, I think when I was reflecting while reading this book, I thought of sometimes when like you do something, like, I don't know, with like your friends, if they invite you to like an event or something and you say, I guess sort of still saying yes, but you say yes. And then like later on you have these like feelings like, oh, I shouldn't go. And so like, maybe you start like, I don't know, gossiping or chatting with like other people besides those people who invited you, like, oh, every time they invite me, like, I don't, they should understand that I'm busy. Like, why do they keep inviting me and things? Like, why do they keep asking me, you know, to borrow money or something? Like, they should just like know that I have a hard time or something. But it's like, that's Porous, when like you keep allowing these different things to continue, when like the flip side, which we'll talk about, is like the healthy is like telling them, actually, I cannot do this for XYZ reason. So I think that's another way to look at it.
Yes. Also, for those of you who are, you know, entrepreneurs or even just any work, anybody who works on the computer, especially with this pandemic, like, Porous boundary is someone emailing you and it's your day off and or you're off work and they're like, you know what, I can just send this. I'll just respond, even though they sent it when you know you're not working. That's violating our, that's what we're trying to say too. Like, we violate our own boundaries. Like, we could have been like, oh, I'm off the clock. Like, I'm done, I'm gone. But then, you know, with this thing right here, and you get them emails on your phone, we find ourselves easily violating our own boundaries. Porous, answering a quick email, like, oh, quickly, yes or no. And we're like, yes, but that's, we're not working. So those are things that like, they just add up. When I think about porous boundaries, I think of like pores on your skin. They just add up.
Yeah.
They don't seem exactly significant, but this, it adds up. I'm going to watch my mouth.
And yeah, that's a great example. Cause yeah, like when it comes to like emails or even texts or calls, like if you're busy, like I still am working through this of like, Tony, you don't need to text someone back like right away or call them back. Like if you are literally in the middle of doing a task, like if I'm cooking or something, and it really is just not a good time, like it's just fine to then respond later. So that could even be like with friends, you know, with family or whatever. That's something I've realized about myself. Sometimes even if I'm not available, I will answer. And like, of course, there's some people who ask you like, oh, is this a good time? But not everyone, when they call you, will ask if this is a good time. And then sometimes even if they ask you if this is a good time, you'll say, no, it's not. And then they proceed to continue the conversation. So sometimes I've learned that it's better to just like, okay, my boundary is like to not answer if I'm like working on something. So then later on, I could just get back to it. So I think that's important. And Alyssa, you were saying, oh yeah, it's like, you were saying how like us as individuals tend to violate our own boundaries. And yes, that's something that Nidra shares a lot in the beginning of the book. It's like, this book helps us not only create boundaries with other people, but my biggest takeaways again is just like boundaries with myself. So also a porous example for me is like my self-care. Like, and I really like reading right when I wake up in the morning. And then for me, I like throughout the pandemic, sometimes I'm like, okay, like instead of reading in the morning, like I'll do it at night. And then of course life happens and I don't do it at night. But when I'm actually like really good about like, no, Tony, you dedicated this time right when you woke up to read, I feel better. And that also like if I'm doing something or have meetings, like I know to not schedule it during like, you know, that time in the morning that I have for my like routine. So I think that's important too. Like if you think about how you're taking care of yourself, I think a lot of times we have porous boundaries with ourselves, like what, you know, our self-care looks like, you know, taking time for rest. Like maybe we're off a certain day and then we still end up doing work stuff or doing stuff mm-hmm. with family when we really wanted to just be by ourselves. So I think that's important too.
Yes. And I wanted to share a quote, setting boundaries is self-care. Again, like what Tony is saying. Shall we talk about rigid boundaries?
Yes. So porous is like, you know, like pores, like fluid, you know, it's just like maybe there's a boundary, maybe there's not. Rigid is the opposite and is what you think of rigid. So boundary right here. Nope, don't play with me.
I can't cross this.
Yeah. So rigid is the other extreme. The lesson reading in the book. Rigid boundaries involved in all to keep others out as a way to keep yourself safe. But staying safe by locking yourself is unhealthy and leads to a whole other set of problems. And so Porous boundaries, Nidra says, leads to unhealthy closeness, where rigid boundaries are like a self-protective mechanism. So to protect yourself, you are rigid, but then it builds this distance. A lot of that is rooted in like not wanting to be vulnerable, not wanting to be taken advantage of. So it could be, you know, like a trauma response or those kind of things, and it manifests as rigid boundaries. And so they look like never sharing. So if you like are very private, reserved, and like maybe your coworkers know like nothing about your personal life, or like your family knows like nothing about like how your work is doing. And then there's like building walls. So like we said, like, you know, like just distancing yourself from like whoever, people, avoiding vulnerability. So like not even opening up yourself because you're just like, nope, I'm not even gonna let these people like come close to me to hurt me. You know what I mean? Cutting people out. So you're just like, actually, maybe I tried having porous boundaries and it was not working. So you know what? I'm just gonna cut that whole person scenario out of my life. It could look like having high expectations of others. So just like, well, I do this boundary. Like, I get up at 5 a.m. every day and run. Like, why can't they do that? You know what I mean? So it could be, you know, kind of projecting or like just having expectations for others that are not even what they want for themselves. And then she says also enforcing strict rules. So boundaries could be like, no, like I never, you know, hang out with my coworkers. And say, you might have one coworker that's kind of cool, you know, you don't care, like, never them. Or like, you know, like some people will be like, I don't know, like they, I'm trying to think of another like more casual example.
I mean, what I wanted to bring up about rigid versus porous. So I wanted to say, like, you know, rigid, like, oh, when someone says like, yeah, I have strict boundaries. Like Nidra's also highlighting that, no, rigid is another extreme. It's another unhealthy extreme on the spectrum. So here's porous, here's rigid. And what really, really hit me deep, y'all, in this list is cutting people out. Call me Edwina Scissorhands. Cause I'd be like, bye, bye, bye. You know, Edward, why you call myself Edwina?
I got what you were saying. It was just real funny.
Just call me Edwina because I'm so porous and because I have this way of like being like unhealthy closeness. When I feel so like my boundaries are violated, I don't know how to express them. So I just, Edwina, cut them out. Just, and I just be like, where'd she go? She gone. And so. She need to cut it. That's how I realized, like, that's not sustainable to be like all over here or like over here. You know, I'm just trying to be in the middle. I'm very, y'all, you can tell I'm a dancer because I'm just embodying everything. But boundaries.
Yeah, so it's funny because, not funny, I had reflected and realized that I'm a person that usually has more rigid boundaries. So when I was
let us know in the comments if you're like that, please.
Oh, I thought you were gonna say if you know that Tony's rigid. I was like,
no. Let us know if you more identify with, at this point, now that I'm gonna let you finish your story, but in the comments while you're telling your story, let us know if you identify more with porous or rigid.
Yeah, let us know if you're porous. P for porous, R for rigid.
Yeah, give us a P or R or a PR. Prr, you know what I'm saying? We have a little too much fun. Okay, Tony, go ahead and share with us your rigid story.
Well, I was just saying, I was reflecting while reading this book and I was like, wow, like I really am rigid. Like I have walls. I'm the Great Wall of China over here. Like she's at Weena Scissorhands. I'm like the Great Wall of China. Like I've built a fortress. You would like to come in. Well, guess what? There's a moat. So you have to like take like a donkey up the mountain and then you need to scan. You know, like we have to do like ancestry.com to make sure, like, who are you? Why are you here? And why did you think that you could come up inside this wall? You know,
so you see how complicated these rigid boundaries can get, y'all. This is why it's not healthy.
Yeah. And I also,
energy, right?
I also cut people out. I avoid vulnerability. Recently, I talked to someone about this. Like, wow, I've been actually really vulnerable with you. Like, this is really interesting because, like, I don't do this. So I was self-aware enough to realize in the moment as it was happening, but I'm still working through, like, being okay with, like, not this rigidness. But in the last year, I feel like I have definitely, like, worked on this. And so I'm getting better with like even like Alyssa, like we're sisters. So I talked to her more about like my personal life, because even like people close to me like really didn't know what was going on. So I'm working on that. Oh, Gaia says, I too have been known to have an ice box where my heart used to be.
Okay, Omarion.
Right? And so examples of rigid could be like saying no harshly as a way to discourage people from asking you in the future. So you're like, no, I'm never going to do that. It also be like having a rule where you, this example says like, you never watch your sister's kids, or like you never, you know, help out a coworker when they ask for a favor, you know what I mean? So it can look like a lot of things.
I think it's interesting that Larry says it's okay to cut people out. It is healthy for me. Friends, people can just be friends after. Yes. And Nisha does talk into detail, like the, like why cutting people out is more unhealthy than, you know, what people normally say, like, oh, cutting out is good. Like you should cut people out. I'm trying to find it where she says it though.
Well, like something, just kind of explain it as this is like, I think in the book when she talks about cutting people out, I was like, you've gotten so fed up with like not having a healthy boundary that you just basically kind of ghost. You just never, you're like, I just am never going to interact
with you. I found it. Yeah. It's on page 45. If y'all have the book, cutoff. The cutoff is when you abruptly cut, abruptly without explanation, disconnect from another person before you cut them off. Ask yourself this, like they're saying to be a little bit mindful of that. Cause that's just an abrupt, like, gone. Ah! Why did you fall, y'all? The cord didn't catch you, girl. Anyway,
takes a tumble.
Are y'all watching live or not? Okay, so
we're giving you pure entertainment right now. Cut off below if you're laughing.
Before you cut someone off, ask yourself these questions: was the other person aware of my issues with the relationship? Two, have I tried setting a boundary first? Three, did I uphold my boundary and hold the other person accountable? And those are the things where I'm like, wow, I was called out. Cause I've definitely been like more of a person that does the cutoff. And that's, it's, I just feel it's a very, I don't know the best way to say it, but it just feels, it takes more energy because now there's just like, it's like a space, a gap, you know, a break in the relationship with somebody. And it has the capability of repeating itself.
Yeah.
Now, that's what I learned.
In the book, she shares how like through creating healthy boundaries, so communicating with people when it's like, instead of being rigid and cutting them off, like she really advocates for communicating through that. Like, even though it might be difficult, it's gonna be uncomfortable. Like none of this, setting boundaries is not comfortable. She says that a lot. Like you're gonna have to get comfortable being uncomfortable, because you know, telling someone like, oh, hey, like, actually, like, you know, like I work these hours, and like when you email me, you know, after the hours, like I know it's urgent to you, but like I have XYZ things, that could be uncomfortable. You know, like maybe there's a power dynamic, you know, maybe that's your friend and your coworkers, so like you want to help them out. You know, there's different things that, there's a lot of emotions, I guess, that come into like boundaries and why we feel fearful to enforce them. Mm-hmm. But yeah, you know, cutting off is that drastic of like, I don't even want to deal with this. But the healthy thing, and Nidra's a therapist, of course, she's like, the healthy thing is to talk through it, to work through it, to let people know that like, this is what's happening, and like, give them, that's giving them the opportunity to improve and to take action on the thing. It's like she said in the book, it's like holding them accountable. Cause it's like, if you don't even tell someone, hey, you're actually kind of violating my boundary, how are they supposed to know? And then they're going to keep thing in that way, or keep
yes.
in that way. So it does, it's a disservice to you and that person, honestly.
And I wanted to also share a couple quotes and gems. She, Nidra says, boundaries are not unspoken rules. So if you found yourself saying they should have known better, or it's common sense, that is an assumption that someone should know. Social boundaries, personal boundaries, familiar boundaries. So if you catch yourself saying that, which I have caught myself saying that, then it's like, well, that person doesn't know. So like, you, we can gossip all we want about this person being reckless or da 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 da, but we're not communicating our boundary around that person's actions around us or around others. And I also want to share another quote, Jem, is healthy boundaries are possible when your past doesn't show up as your present interactions. Let me say it again for the ones in the back. Healthy boundaries, because now we talked about porous and rigid. Healthy boundaries are possible when your past doesn't show up as your present interactions, y'all. And before we move to healthy interactions, I want to highlight some people who are sharing what they think. Gaia says she feels like she's definitely more porous when it comes to work. I definitely feel you on that. Chanel shares, I can be rigid or porous depending on the mood. Mood swing, right? Here. Lipe says, oof, I don't know what that's from, but oof, was it from my fall? I don't know.
I feel it.
Was it the tea? And then Larry says, I used to think that you could be vulnerable with everyone. In reality, you need to be careful with who you, with how you are vulnerable, because some people don't really know how to handle that in a respectful and appropriate manner. Yes, exactly. Not everyone can handle that and hold space for us. So that is a boundary, knowing that boundary within ourselves, and also understanding that other people might not have the capacity. Mm-hmm. So that is a great self-awareness tip. And then Gaia says, yes, huge advocate for teaching people how you like to be treated. Mm-hmm. And then Jada says, I don't know. I'm all about that cutoff life. I mean, Edwina right here. But yes, always a good practice to try and work through things. That's what I'm trying to do. I'm trying to sustain the relationships that I have with people and really not just cut off a whole person because there's just one part that's trash. You know, we can discuss that.
Yeah. Or it's like, you know, just at least having the discussion of like why you're cutting someone off. I mean, obviously you probably wouldn't word it like that. I'm cutting you off. But you'd be like, hey, this has been, you know, keep happening. And this is a pattern. Like it's not healthy for me to continue this relationship thing, you know?
Yeah. I also want to say that we're not talking about, we're not talking about abuse. We're not talking about all those kind of things. Like, we're not talking about like not cutting off that kind of stuff. Cause Nija also talks about that in the opening sections of like, you know, the cost of not having healthy boundaries. And she touches a little bit on that. We won't get into those details, but I want to say also too, like, I don't want to normalize like that kind of talk to of like, if you need to cut somebody off for your safety, like that's what she, in her definition, she talked about safety. And you feeling comfortable. If you don't feel safe or comfortable to explain your boundaries, then you probably aren't safe enough. Like, so ask yourself this too. Like, when we're talking about this, we're not like, oh yeah, tell everyone your boundaries. Like, in the cases that you feel like you can't, you know, that's also a good check-in. Maybe you're not in a safe space. So I just want to also say that too. Like, we're not here to just like preach or anything like that. We're just reflecting and responding to the book and our own experiences, but we don't want to like trivialize boundaries in that way.
Yeah, but also I think going into what we're talking about earlier, like having boundaries with yourself. So I think that's the first, like, she doesn't really word it this way, but I think the most important boundary is with yourself. Like, she talks about relationships and all this stuff, but like if you have the boundary with yourself that you want to feel safe and comfortable and like understood and seen and validated in like whatever aspects of your life, then if you're in situations that aren't that, then you can honor your boundary and, you know, find a way to not be in that situation. So I think it's also mm-hmm. really important, like the self-reflection of like, okay, how am I honoring myself? And she talks a lot mm-hmm. about that towards the end of the book. And we'll talk about that towards the end of this month. But yeah, those are all great reflections. I feel like a lot of us feel seen and heard from these different boundaries. We can take that with a grain of salt and, you know, take some time this next week to reflect on how that sits with us and, mm-hmm. you know, things that we might want to, you know, incorporate in our life. But yeah, I can share her definition of healthy just so we're all on the same page. And then we can kind of wrap up a little bit and share a few reflection questions with you all to take away for this next week, because we kind of give you all homework, like a fun thing. You don't have to do it, but just something to think about before we meet up next week. So before we end, healthy boundaries are possible. Oh, like Alyssa said that, possible when your past does not show up as your present situations. And she also says that healthy boundaries require an awareness of emotional, mental, and physical capacity. So that went into a lot of what we're talking about, is that self-reflection, self-awareness, and clear communication. So a lot of what she talks about in this book is communication. Like communication is key. Like a lot of it really is just that and being more assertive in that. So examples of healthy boundaries are being clear about your values. You're like, this is really important to me to have like family time. So when I'm not working, please respect that I'm not going to answer because this is my family time. Listening to your own opinion. Listen to yourself, girl. Sharing with others appropriately. So, like Larry was kind of saying, like choosing who and when to be vulnerable, having a healthy vulnerability with people who've earned your trust, earned, or not everyone just gets it, being comfortable saying no. So that's kind of goes back to what we were talking about in the beginning. And then comfortable hearing no as well. So that's what healthy looks like. But we'll share some reflection questions and then we'll wrap up.
Yes, so of course we want to share that healthy boundaries are a life practice. It is a life practice. And that's why we thought it was really important to go through this book with our community. And so as part of our life practice for the Soul Tree Sisters and our soul care is journal prompts. Like that's part of our practice in soul care. So it wouldn't be right if we didn't give our community a little opportunity to reflect and journal. So the first question we're wanting to throw at y'all is, how were boundaries taught to you and your family? Feel free to write this down if you want to, but also feel free in the chat if you want to let us know, like, how were boundaries taught to you and your family? I can say for me, boundaries were taught to me when I was first little, but like, don't touch that, it's hot. You know, don't do this. Like, so it could be as simple as like as that. But how are boundaries taught to you? And then Tony has shared in the chat the reflection question. So you can also see that as well. Our second question is, where are you in need of boundaries right now? List three places or relationships where you would like a new boundary. I know for me, I would like to have a new boundary within myself. So that's, I'm working with myself. I'm starting here.
Yeah, with me, like through the first part of the book was like boundaries. That's really navigating and work.
All right, and then the third one
And
is, I'm sorry, we're getting a little. Can you hear me? Okay.
I
And
can
then the
hear you.
third one is, what is your biggest challenge with setting boundaries? And when I think about that, because I just said I want to set a boundary with myself, what is my biggest challenge with setting boundaries with myself? Well, I'm with myself. Like and for me, it's like my biggest challenge with setting boundaries with myself is the fact that I'm not sharing them with others. And that for me, this is why I really am looking to do this reflection in community with the Soul Tree Sister community and our Soul Tree Sanctuary fam, is because I do crave that accountability. And when it comes to setting boundaries with myself, I feel like I haven't really been able to activate those because I just violate them and I start all over again. It's like when we talk about like maybe you're trying to practice a new like activity or something like that. A lot of times for me, it helps when I vocalize them and share them. So part of us having these lives is like for us to all bear witness to each other's growth and reflections. And so I want to welcome you all to share. If you want to, start this journey with us, comment. You're already here with us. Join. And so that's for me. Like my biggest challenge is like the lack of not having accountability, and that's why I love bringing these kind of growth opportunities to the Soul Tree Sanctuary, because I feel like we can do it collectively as a community and healthily.
Yeah, for me, what I'm working on right now is maintaining my boundaries with self within my daily routine. So I'm trying to get back into having a routine because I just graduated my master's program. So I had like a few weeks of a break, but then now I got used to like not really having a schedule, but that doesn't help my self-care. Like I really like to dedicate certain times of the day for certain activities because that's the most like productive I am, et cetera. So I want to get back to that. And I haven't been having that boundary. I've been like just doing things whenever, and I haven't felt good about it. So yeah, and like Alyssa said, it's kind of hard when you have to motivate your own self or like, you know, enforce your own boundary because there's not really that person to tell you like, no, this isn't what you said.
Yes. And then Larry shares with us how he learned about boundaries. He says, in my family, they didn't really set boundaries and have conversations about boundaries. So, but it's something that he would like to move forward with teaching his daughter. Yes. Sophia is so lucky to have a papa like you that's going to model good boundaries. That's great.
Yeah. So thank you all for sharing with us today and our first day of our book club series. So again, join us each Sunday for the rest of June. Same time, same place. So 5 p.m. Pacific time, 8 p.m. Eastern time on Facebook Live. Again, the recordings will be offered to our Soul Tree Sanctuary members. So go to our website, soultreesisters.com, to find out how to join. And of course, with the reflection questions, you can see it in the comment and maybe copy it and paste it so you can journal and reflect on that this next week. And then next week, we will be talking about the different types of boundaries. So work, family, relationships.
Aren't there six different ones?
Yeah. So the six different boundaries. And then we'll be doing like chapter 4 and 5. So a little bit about, let me look at the table of contents, about the six types and then what boundary violations look like. So if someone's not honoring it, what that looks like. So again, if you don't have the book, you can still come back for a great conversation, but please do check out this book. You can support a Black woman who's doing awesome work in the community. So definitely yes. Support. And if you can't, then check it out from your library. And if you do buy the book online, you can buy it from her website, or you can buy it from, if you go to her website, there's a link to support an independent bookstore near you. So I'm really passionate about that too. So try not to order from like a big box store if you can.
Yes. And I also want to share that this live will be available for 24 hours. And then once it's after 24 hours, it's going to be available on our Soul Tree Sanctuary. Again, if you're like, wow, I want to be able to like revisit this past 24 hours. Again, if you're part of our Soul Tree Sanctuary community, you'll have access to that past 24 hours. Otherwise, we will see y'all next week.
Yes. Bye.
Bye. Have a great week.